Thank you, Jonathan. Well, hello, everybody. So today we're going to talk about building space planning and component-based design. As you know, until 2017, building space planning was a little bit a standalone product, I would say. The process flow between conceptual to detail wasn't so obvious. And today I would like to show you that with 2018, 18X actually, and with the component-based design approach, we are able to move smoothly from a conceptual design to a detailed design, okay? So I prepared this small presentation here. It's nothing official. I just put some pictures together just to explain you the concept. The concept is what? It would be to start with building space planning, design your building, design all your architectural features, the walls, the panels, everything. And as you know, in building space planning, you have features. So here on this image, we have a wall. And the goal is in building space planning to assign some specification to this wall. We'll do that through an object type. I will show you what is an object type. And thanks to this object type, we'll be able to automatically, I would say, transform using templates this wall into a detailed wall like this one here. And you see the product structure containing a complete assembly with all the elements of the wall. Okay. If we use another sample with spaces, we have on the left, using building space planning, the space reservation. And of course, we can assign some specification to these spaces and automatically after instantiate the detailed representation of each of these space. Okay. This is done, there's a specific setup in order to do that. And the goal is to create an object type. The object type, what is it? It's a table resource, mainly, with some attributes. But it's like a specification. If you want to create a wall with studs, you know, so you will start to create a product, an assembly, with a skeleton, usually. You always have the skeleton of your wall, and all the parts of the wall. It can be all the layers, the studs, the insulation, things like that. From this product, you will create a template. Okay. The very important thing in this process is to identify the right input of the template. And we'll see that the input is dictated by building space planning. And then once you have this template, you will attach this template to an object type. So the object type will be a wall object type. And in the resource table, you will assign this template as the product detail design resource. Okay? And then you will be able to attach this object type to a conceptual wall and automatically generate a detail wall. And the goal, of course, is to be fully associative. So here, for a space, if you change your, I didn't finish my presentation, but if you change your detail, your conceptual representation, so here, I just have a single space in building space planning, I stretch it, okay, to increase the space, automatically, I want my detail representation to update and to morph based on the modification I applied on my conceptual model. One very important thing to do that is to identify what are the references for the templates. When you create a wall in building space planning, the template that you create we'll need to have the meat surface as input. Okay, so in the wall feature, when we create a wall feature, there's a meat surface that is computed. And when we assign an object type to this wall, we will take the meat surface as input of the template. Okay? A slab, it will be the top surface. A beam, it will be a center curve and the section, and so on. So this table gives all the inputs that you need to have in your template in order to do this process. Okay? Something important, it's also if you want to start and play with object types and building space planning, we deliver in the 3D experience installation, okay, under the B420 WinB64 resources, AEC content, CBD object types, a set of predefined, already created object types. So you just need to import these 3D XMLs, okay, and then you will be able to use them in building space planning. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to use them in a demonstration. So if we look step by step, we have a wall in building space planning. Okay, and what we'll do, using the publish, so here under the building tab, if you extend it, you have a publish button. Okay, so with the publish button, you're going to select the wall feature, and automatically Katia will list all the different wall object types available. Okay, so you will select the object type that you want to assign to your wall, and automatically it will create a publication on this wall. This is the first step. So when you do that, it means that you assign a specification to this wall. You say, oh, this wall, it's a wall, it's a sandwich wall. Okay. Then, still in building space planning, inside the building toolbar here, you have a change level of development tool. So this tool will allow you to automatically expose the template, which is captured in the object type. So it will automatically instantiate this template onto this wall. Okay? So you have a dedicated interface where, so if you publish several walls, you will see all the walls here. And if it's blue, it means that you are able to expose your wall product, your detailed wall, into building space planning. Okay. What I propose is to show you live all that. So I'm going to show you the wall example and then the spaces also. So for the wall, my first step has been to create a wall product. So this is a facade, actually. It's an exterior facade. It's a wall plus a brick facade. So you can see there are several components, several layers, insulations, plastic layers, wood frame, bricks, and so on. Okay? Once I have done this facade, I have created second step, my template. And for the template, okay, as we have seen in this table, for a wall, my input needs to be a meat surface. So the input of my template for the wall is a meat surface. Okay, so I have designed all this assembly based on a meat surface. Okay, everything is linked to my meat surface and only to my meat surface. I haven't used any planes or reference planes or whatever. Okay, all your design needs to be linked to only one single feature, the bit surface. And then I have created the object type. So the object type is here. So it's a resource table in which I point my template. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to, here I have a building that I've done in building space planning. So you see we are missing some walls, some spaces, some stuff. And then what I propose is to start to design some exterior walls. Okay. So let's work on the first floor. The ground story, actually. On this ground story here, so I'm going to expand a little bit my tree. I have a sketch. It's a simple line here on this slab. And on this line, I'm going to use this sketch to design a building space planning wall. Okay. I'm going to change the thickness, 0.2. Up. Like that. Okay, and I validate. So if I extend a little bit my specification tree, you can see the wall here. Okay, this is my wall. So now on this wall, I want to assign the object type. So I click here on this toolbar, I extend it, and I have my publish command. I select the publish, select my wall. Okay. And you see that automatically I have the available types for wall. I have three different types. The brick facade that I've created, and these two other walls are two object types that are delivered inside the code. You know, the 3D XML that I've shown you under the installation, I have imported these three 3D XMLs. So now they are available here to use. So me, in this case, I'm going to use the brick facade wall type and click publish. So here you see the wall, and when I click publish, it will create a publication here. Okay, that points to this wall. So here I have assigned a specification. Okay. So now if I want to expose this, this specification and create my detailed wall, I'm just going to activate my ground story assembly. Okay. Let's zoom a little bit on this wall. And then still under the building toolbar, I'm going to extend it. And here I have the change level of development functionality. Okay. So here, what do I have? I have this specification wall one. Okay. Which is linked to this object type. And in this object type, I have a product that I can expose because it's blue. I don't have a feature that I can expose. No need to expose a feature because my feature wall, it's this one, the one created from building space planning. But I have this product that I can expose, this detailed product. So I'm going to select it. And here, I'm going to say I want to expose the product. Okay. And I click process. So here what it's doing, it's automatically looking for my wall, looking for the mid-surface, and on this mid-surface, it instantiates my template. It's done. And here I have my detail wall. Okay. So you can see the different layers here. The studs, the different insulation layer, and so on. Now, what is nice, it's my detail wall is fully associative with my conceptual wall. So first modification that that we can do, if I click on my wall here, I can edit feature, I can modify, let's say, the thickness. 0.4. And you see that if I hide actually this one, my detail wall has been updated. Okay. Now let's say that I want to continue to work in building space planning and assign some instantiate some windows. So let's go for Windows standard. Let's take the fixed. And here I instantiate one window here, one here, one here, and one here. Validate. So I'm going to hide the wall. So you see here the windows have been instantiated in building space planning. And if I show my wall here, you see that the windows and the openings have been automatically performed into my detail wall. So if I hide, you're going to see, if I hide now the different elements of my wall, let's hide this one, let's hide this one, the insulation. You see, I have created my template only using the mid-surface, and because now my mid-surface has some kind of opening inside, all my different parts adjust based on these modifications. So here it's not very exact, but you can put after plenty of knowledge into your stud wall, okay, to make sure that all the studs comes in line with the openings and things like that. Okay. And at any time, if I select, where are my windows? Okay. If I select a window and move it, automatically everything adjusts. Okay. So now let's do the same with spaces. So still we're going to stay on the ground floor, and here I'm going to use the Space Browser. So the Space Browser, it's the capability. In fact, I have all my spacing elements that are all my spaces are defined inside an Excel file. You see. Here I have a module. In fact, I have created some prefabricated module, standard modules. Okay. One module, it's a bedroom and a facade with a facade. I have three of those. Here are the dimensions of these modules, the color of the modules. There's no walls. I have another one. It's a kitchen and bathroom in the corner of the building. I have three of those with the dimensions and so on. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to import this Excel file in my Space Browser. So I'm going to use my Space Browser to instantiate automatically these spaces. So you see, I have different, I retrieve all the different units that will define my Excel file. So here I select a kitchen bathroom in the corner of the building. I had three of those. So I pick a first one and automatically I position it here on my floor. Okay. Now I select another module that I position it on the side here. And then let's take some other modules. So here I can drag this module up to the edge. Automatically it will rotate. And then I'm going to position it on the border like that. And you see each time that I position a module, it is consumed in the Space Browser because there's a small color here. And the last one here, this one should be in this like that, in this orientation. I snap it to the other one and like that. Okay. I have my four species. And just to finish, I'm going to create, so those are predefined species. They come from my Excel file. Those are standard. I would say out of the box species. They are prefabricated. They are not parametric. Okay. It's a standard modules that I can fabricate one by one in a factory. Now I'm going to create a custom space here on my floor with no walls. And I'm going to snap it here like that. Pull on the faces to change its dimension. And this one, it will be a custom space, okay, fully parametric. I validate. Et OK, it disappeared. No, it's still here. OK, so I have my five species. Let's close that. So let's have a look in the spectre. I have my five species that are here. And now what we're going to do, we're going to assign some object types to this species, because I have created, okay, or previously, object types for each of these types of modules. So, same methodology. I'm going to use the publish, okay. I'm going to select my species, okay. So the command here is telling me that for species, I have all these different types available. So for each of my species, I can assign any of this type. So of course, what I will try to do, I will assign the right ones, because some of these species needs to be in the corner of the building. So I want them to be to make sure that my design is correct. Okay. And for the last space, the green space here, I am assigning a custom space. Okay. This custom space, it's a detailed space, which is fully parametric. Okay. I publish. So you see here on the left, under my publication, now I see that all my species have been published and the object types have been assigned to each of these spaces. So now to expose that, I activate my my ground story and use the change level of development capability to expose all the spaces. So you see here the change level of development command has detected that I have already exposed a wall. Okay, so for sure, I don't want to expose it again. Or what I can do, I can filter. So what I will do here, I'm going to select all these object types here. So I didn't assign a right, okay. So here I multi-select all the species that I want to instantiate. Okay. I want to expose the corresponding products. And I click on process. So here for each of these species, Katia will look at the object type that has been assigned to each of these space. Inside the object types, there's a template that has been assigned, and it will automatically instantiate this template inside the assembly. And we see here that the different modules, detailed modules, start to appear. And now we are just missing the custom space. OK, it's done. So here I am inside my building. So here I have both my detail modules and the spaces. I'm going to filter and hide the spaces. And you can see here that I have all the different detail modules. So each of these modules are composed of, so it can be components such as a bed, a sofa, and so on. But I have doors, I have walls, I have a facade wall for this module, and so on. Okay. And of course, so if I show again my spaces, these modules, detail modules, are fully, if I move a space here, okay, the corresponding module, the detail module, will move you with it. Sorry, not this one, this one. Okay. Now let's have a look to this custom module. So here, let's change the view type here. Let's be in. I was already like that. Let's see what I have inside. So you see, I have some piping, a washing machine, a sink, and a pipeline for the evacuation of the water. Okay, for the drainage. I have a wall, a window. Okay. Let's go back to building space planning, and you can see also that the window is always positioned in the longest side of this space. You see, this is the longest, this is the shortest. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to select my space here and edit this space, and I'm going to pull on the side here to change its configuration. And you see here, I do a drastic modification. And of course, this module is fully parametric. And here, now the longest side of my module, it's no more this side, but it's this one here. Okay. So I update. And you see that my detail module automatically update based on the definition of my conceptual space. Okay. So I can, once again, if I move this this space here a little bit outside of the building, automatically the space is fully relimited, and my detail module also. Okay. So what do we have? So if we look now at the building space planning tree, under my ground story, I have the windows that I have instantiated. I have my different modules. So you see the kitchen bathroom, it's an assembly composed of many different parts. I have a facade, I have a frame assembly, walls, slab, and things like that. So I have my four and five different modules all together. Okay. So now here, so here inside this tree, we do have a mixed, I would say, a mixed of conceptual and detailed representation of the assembly. Okay. If I take the wall, I have both the conceptual wall, okay, here, and the detailed wall. So now, if we want to have what we call a BIM product structure, okay, we want to export it in IFC, I can activate my building here. So my building is not finished, never mind. Oh yes, what I can do. So this wall here, this conceptual wall, I can copy it. So maybe we can, I can copy it to the different stories here. Move also all the windows. So maybe we can do it quickly. Okay, I'm going to hide this wall here. So I select my conceptual wall, and I'm going to, maybe I can multi-select. I don't know, we'll see. No. Okay, I select this wall, and I'm going to copy to the other stories above, like that.
Should be able to select also the windows.
Yes, okay. I'm going to select also so the windows.
Yeah, they're from the tree is faster.
Yeah, from the tree is faster. So here, up, 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 and copy to story. And I'm going to copy to story 1, 2, 3. Okay. Okay, let's activate. Oh, forgot to select the first story. Never mind. I have my detail wall. So here now I can do the same operation. So what would be nice, it's so if I go to the second story here, I can here again. What would be nice is maybe to be able to publish to a copy with the publication. So here I can publish again this wall here. Has been a brick facade wall type, publish, activate that, and then here I am able to instantiate my detail wall. Okay, it's done, and you see automatically the openings have been performed in my detail wall. Okay. So here I have my building, and if I want to, I'm going to stop here. But if I want now to move to have a detailed product structure, so here, as I said, I have a mixed. Okay. So now we have the capability in building space planning to generate a BIM product structure. So let's convert this assembly into a BIM product structure. So what will it do? We have already here in this assembly some BIM elements, my detailed world and my detailed spaces. Okay, so here you see it has been very fast. My BIM product structure has been created. So let's have a look to the ground story. So you see now we have one part per object. So I have my ground assembly. I have, of course, the volumes for the elevators and for the stairs. The stairs, my curtain wall. And here, under my component, so I have my detailed wall. Okay. It is the same that than the one that I have in the conceptual representation. So maybe what I should do it's this. So wait, how does it work? No, I think it works like that. Okay, I move that and I move that here. Okay, and I tile vertically. Okay. So on the left, I have my product structure from building space planning, and on the right, I have my BIM. So that's why it's called BIM here, BIM product structure. So I have my detail wall, and I have also on the ground story all my spaces. Okay, all the different spaces. I'm going to hide this one here. So you see all the spaces are here. Okay. So now if I come here and make some modifications, so let's activate the ground story. I'm going to click on this space here and move it here. Like that. Okay. So here it will, I think I need to, So if you have the conceptual representation, detailed representation open together, if you redo again a beam product structure, what it will do, it will update, okay, if you generate again the beam product structure, it will update your detailed representation. And you see now that my detail space has been updated based on the modification of my conceptual representation. Okay? It's the same for everything. If I change, if I add a window or if I remove a window, everything will update in this detail model. Okay? So here now, so regarding, let's have a look to story one. So you see story one, in building space planning, we had just a conceptual wall. Okay, so here now, in story one, I have a detailed wall. It's a part, okay, a part which represents this wall. Okay, and on the ground story here, of course, we have a detailed wall, but not the conceptual wall, because here we have instantiated the detail wall. On the beam product structure, we keep only the detail representation. The conceptual representation do not exist anymore because we don't need it. Okay. So now what I can do with that, I am able to export that into IFC. Okay. So it's very powerful to and very nice to be able to have this smooth change level of development, okay, from conceptual to detail, where directly now in your conceptual representation, you are able to apply some detailing directly in your conceptual model. Okay, you, and you can select, in fact, you will define on which element you want to apply some details. Okay. Do you guys have any question? Everything is crystal clear. Oh, everybody's lost.
Yeah, no. Hi, Thomas. It's Graham. So the, I find that, well, occasionally the facades are independent of the spaces, and they might be driven by the, perhaps the edge of the slab. Is there a workflow that could work with that?
So you're talking about this facade that I did in my wall here? You want it to be driven by the edge of the slab?
Yes. So in prefab, for example, the it's not always modular because you'll be carting around a lot of fresh air around the countryside. So frequently it's panelized. So the structure goes up and then facade panels then attach to the, you know, between the slabs.
I see what you mean. So it means it attached to the slab. So here, basically, you could use yes. Well, actually, so the slabs would be because, in fact, you need to attach an object type. Okay, your template to a building space planning feature. Okay, so for your facade, you could use the wall, but you need to use this edge and this edge, correct? These two edges as input of your template.
Yeah, that would.
That'd be
reasonable. Yeah, I think
yes.
So, yeah.
So since the mid surface, so the output of the BDP feature here, it's a mid surface. So you know the mid surface and you know the thickness of the wall. You know those are. If you take a wall here. You are able, what you get from the BTP feature, it's a wall thickness and a mid surface. So using the mid surface and the thickness, you are able to recreate this face and the top and bottom edge and create your template, your facade template using that. Am I clear? No?
Yeah, no, no, it makes sense. I think I just need to have a play, see how it works, because I might need multiple panels along that length, for example.
Mm-hmm. Yes, but after in your template, you know, you can put plenty of knowledge where.
Yeah, of course.
So this is where all the knowledge would be, yes, in your template, where you make sure you have all the panels, the right size and everything. Here, you see the concept here, it's really to be able to provide through conceptual features, some geometry on which we can attach an object type to automatically instantiate a template. So we need to make sure that in all the building space planning features, we have the necessary inputs to create the templates with all the information that we need. So each BDP feature provides some geometric feature that you can use in your template as input and also some parameters. Okay. So if I go to my facade template, the mid surface of my facade is the input and the parameter, I have the wall thickness, you know, as defined in this table. So after all the tricky thing is to create your template correctly. You would create only your surface, okay? Your mid surface. You start by creating your mid surface. It's what I did. I created, I think, a surface somewhere here. I think it's this one. Okay, this is my mid surface. I think it's this one, or yes, no, it's this one. Okay. I created a mid surface with some openings because my wall could have some openings, and then all the rest, all my parts are linked to just this surface. And also based on the wall thickness. With these two inputs, you need to be able to create your full template. Okay. So in your case, you create a mid surface, you create an offset of maybe the half of the thickness, you create another surface, and then you select the extremum, the on the up on the bottom, you recreate the edges, and you use your this geometry to create your facade. Okay, but here the goal is really for us to provide a tool, a methodology to go smoothly from conceptual to detailed design. Okay.
Yeah, and I'm trying to think if I think, Thomas, you had the right answer to this question, because inside your templates you can embed any type of knowledgeware.
Exactly.
And if you really wanted to get sophisticated with this approach, you could even, using the architectural detail designer role along with the along with component-based design, you could embed specifications within the template and do a change LOD twice over. So you do a change LOD to instantiate one template, and then once you have instantiated that template, you do another change LOD to instantiate your anchors and to instantiate panels within a template.
Yep, it's possible.
So yeah, there's you could have a two-step process to go from a conceptual model to a fabrication model if you weren't able to embed all of your details into the first template.
Yeah, I know, Jonathan, that you like to embed things into things.
Little Russian doll.
Exactly. Yeah.
But the question I have now is, because I hadn't seen this Excel sheet that you have that shows the,
So yes, I will publish it. So
this
this
is
Excel,
good. And the question I have, though, the question I have for the group and for everybody on the call is, were the right geometry inputs for component-based design identified? And what, if not, what needs to change? Because through use, you might find that the mid-surface plus the wall thickness isn't enough if the wall has a, if you don't want the wall centered on the mid-surface. So are there, because this is the first release, this first patch was, you know, could be improved on.
A good example would be for the space. So for the space, what is delivered? It's a space datum. So here for my conceptual space, if I go to my catalog, maybe I had to create a volume. Okay. Where is my conceptual space? So it's custom space here. Let's open it. Okay, so what I did, I created a body. Okay, and from this body, I had to create all the walls, everything. And it's not always easy because, you know, a body, a space in building space planning can have different orientation. So sometimes it can be very tricky. To understand which side is the longest side, which side is the shortest one, and things like that. So we can do that with KnowledgeWare, of course. But for that, an axis system would be also sometimes could be useful to use to position all the components and to recreate your geometry.
Incidentally, I think in FD02, I think you could do these spaces as reference without having a template, so you will also have an axis.
So you will deliver an axis or yes?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Well, yes and no. You could instantiate those modular fixed size spaces as a reference instead of doing an engineering template, which I think would be easier.
Okay.
Remember, we discussed this the
Yes,
first time.
yes, 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 yes.
So that is coming. I was also wondering, listening at the discussion before, is there a case to have a tool in building space planning to split the wall before applying the templates?
Oh, it would be. To split the walls actually, you know, it would be nice. It would be nice because when we want to do 4D planning of a building or things like that, you know, maybe these walls will be built in 3D three different times. And if from BDP we're able to split this wall in three, then automatically would have three different parts, and then for 4D planning it will be easier. Well, are you planning to deliver such a tool or?
Well, I'm planning, I'm exploring what is that we do next.
But
Thomas, I think that was really what I was getting at, was that that wall might be made up of many panels.
yeah, so there is the technique of doing the panelization inside the template, and I was wondering if there is a case for doing some of those breakup before, in the constant model before, and then feed each of those to the template.
Yes, maybe it's like when we are able to extract walls. So I think you know that, guys, but when you create a space like that, we're able to extract the different walls. So it would be a little bit, so here I have a space. So here today, I can select this. So I think I can multi-select, Gigi, yes?
Yes.
And we can extract wall.
Yeah, and you can then you can say, do we want one wall or four?
Join walls when possible. What does that mean? If I want four walls,
you want to check that.
Okay. Validate.
So here the breakup is based on the there is a change of direction. So that's how it will break up the walls. To break up one that is a planar or a curved, we would need to have a tool to indicate how to split it. And maybe something similar to the curtain walls UI.
Yeah, exactly. The curtain wall UI actually is good. Huh? It's very good and it's very easy to use. So maybe similar to, yes, I think it would be a nice add-on to be already able to start to break up things.
By the way, as a trick, if you wanted the surface of that wall that is aligned with the slabs, probably if you do a curtain wall there, then the driver from the curtain wall will be exactly the surface, I think.
If I do a curtain wall, yeah, but here I have, it's not a... Oh, yes. Oh, let me check. Can I do a curtain wall here? Wait, I need to be maybe in the... No. Hmm. Not sure I need to be, because this it's a wall. Cannot create. Can I use a wall as a curtain wall?
I don't know. Just try to click on it.
No, it doesn't want. No.
Where is that wall? It is in a story, right?
I can activate the story, yes. It's story one. Curtain wall. Oh, maybe. But why is it selecting the... Okay. So you say that... So if I click OK here... Ooh. Nice. Okay. Wow, this is nice.
And I suspect that the driver for CBD from this feature is the surface, the most external surface, I think. Anyway,
curtain wall, inner surface.
Yeah, inner surface.
Curtain wall surface, I don't know.
Okay. Yes, but yes, it would be very interesting to see what other inputs are useful and if we can compute them, we will compute them.
Yeah, I think from the curtain wall, what you want would be the individual surface panels.
We have been back and forth there on that one. So we didn't really do a lot of work on curtain because it's not clear. We said either the one surface with the mullion punched away, that was one possibility. The one was it's difficult to pass a list to a template. That's the problem. I don't know how to feed a list of objects to a template.
Each surface panel would have to be an individual specification.
Which is what we are doing with the new facade.
Yes, with the tool.
So Thomas, where you put a wall by sketch, I could have multiple walls by sketches along that length, couldn't I?
Yes, you can.
Yes. Let's activate. In a single sketch, you want?
No, I was, well, I'm not absolutely certain, but I was thinking that if I can have multiple walls along a edge of a slab, then I can have multiple panels.
Yes, you can. You will probably have a sketch, and unless the sketch merges the collinear segments.
Oh, if I create, wait, I'm gonna change my view to planar here.
Or maybe if you had a grid there, you could draw, could sketch from grid points to grid points.
Well, actually, I need to create several. Oh, maybe I can. Can we use the outputs feature?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. So let me do that. I can do.
If you really are that nostalgic, you can also put GSM lines there.
Okay, let's create output feature, one here, and one here. Okay. Up, and then so here you will have say two.
Yes, yeah, select the three outputs. You can do it in the same command. You can select three of
Ah,
them.
but it creates a single wall, or?
No, it will have three walls. It will be boolean together, but in the tree, you would have three walls, right?
Correct. Yes, but after it's difficult to know which one is what.
Yeah. If you wanted not to be boolean together, you have to put them in different bodies, which becomes annoying. It takes time.
Yeah. But it's so then you have three walls, so we can. So look what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna publish. I'm gonna select the last three walls.
Yeah.
And here I'm gonna use the sandwich. That's or panelized. I don't know.
I don't use that, don't.
Sandwich is okay.
Yes. So
Okay.
do to two sandwich, one of, and one of your brick facade.
Ah,
Okay.
yes, let's say the middle one, a brick. Publish, activate, change LOD. I'm not sure that my brick facade will be correctly oriented, but we'll see. Process. So we have the sandwich, yes, the brick up. Okay, so my brick is not so. So here, yes, you have three different walls here now, and I think that my.
By the way, the orientation of the wall, now the normal of the face of the mid surface will tell you which one is the exterior.
Okay, cool. And my, but actually, I think I did in my wall. In my template, so I put some. I hope that it will work. A tool to revert it. No, it's not. Oh, no, I didn't. Why you don't have the update here? Update fail. Bon, okay. I have an issue in my template. Oh, here we go. Okay. So here you see, it's a way to do it.
It's a bit tedious, but yes, we can.
And if you go back to the sketcher and change, see this one? Do I have my line here? What's this one? It's not here. Where is my, it's this one. Up. So if you change, oh, sorry guys, I'm trying to find why I don't see my sketch line. Where is it? Où est-ce qu'ils sont ces trucs?
Because you have the profile, so is the black line. Right. You have the output feature there.
So if I change something like that. Hop. Nice. Very nice. And then I can put Windows. No?
Yeah.
Windows works?
Yeah.
Hop. Hop. Wow. Very cool.
That was very cool. So that works with, you could have then different wall types, and you could start to go from your conceptual to detailed model with sketches.
Yes. This is cool.
Yeah, that was what exactly what I was thinking about, yeah.
Okay, so we answered your question.
Yeah, I still think that since the when you create the massing of the building, if you want, you can have the material for the wall created for you quickly. And then, so one possibility is not to do that and then sketch each wall. The other possibility is to let the app create the fake wall, then split it. I don't know which one is faster. I guess sketching gives you a lot more control, of course.
Thomas, you put those walls in the shell and core, is that right?
No. Story one.
You put them in story one. Could you put them in shell and core and span multiple stories, multiple floors?
Oh, I don't think that you can put...
Yes, you can. Yes, you can, spanning multiple stories, I think there is a way to do it now, I forget how. But there are some ways that work and some ways that don't work. It is possible.
What would be nice, Gigi, it's when we create a building, you know, by default, the shell and core, well, yeah. The exterior wall from bottom to the top, it's a single wall for the facade. Mm-hmm. And sometimes maybe we want to break it up by floor. Oh,
you know what you could do, Thomas? You could do this with massings. If you did the different massings, you could then extract the wall. Correct, Gigi? You could extract the external wall and then...
If I create a... Let's,
and then use those extracted walls for...
Unfortunately, no, because we outsmarted ourselves. So even if you stack different masses there, it will add them together and then create a shell around it.
What if you added a millimeter gap between them?
Yes, you can do that.
So what do you want to do here? You see...
Do another sketch that doesn't share the same. Yeah, make that four or five stories.
Yeah, but me, I want a wall here, wall here, wall here, and a wall here. You see,
I think what we are really missing.
And here we have one single wall.
Yeah.
Make a wall from a face of that of the volume, right? So create the thing without walls and then add the walls you want from a face.
Here, when I click on it, it would be nice to say extract walls. I don't. Oh, extract wall. Yeah, but it will be one single wall. Extract walls into floors. Into well, I don't know. But,
yeah, or do a divide.
Divide.
Divide that into a matrix. Yeah, say three columns by three rows, or three rows by story, and then by 20 columns.
See, here the thing is one, and I don't, let's say wall, but that is outside. It's not resting on the slab, it is outside. Ooh. And that, I don't think that is realistic. I mean,
what we're doing though right now is we're really focusing on the facade. We're focusing on how to use, this is facade design, right? With different panel types. And so the division and things, that's, you could use the, yeah, if you had the curtain wall, you could set up you could create your pattern in the curtain wall. And then if you, there was a way to go from change LOD here, but you're using your different wall types even with a curtain wall pattern. Or if you had a curtain wall panel that you added walls to with brick and windows, I think that's where we're going with this conversation at this point.
Yeah, that's where we are going also with the development for the of the new facade tools, right?
Exactly. I wasn't going to say it, but yeah, there's a new facade. There's a lot of work being put into facade design for next year, which would alleviate a lot of this.
But still there is the case where there are walls that rest on the slab. They're not hanging outside, right? It's not a curtain system. It's a wall.
Yeah.
Now, so for that, the workflow that we showed before, you sketch your walls the way you want them. It works. It's a bit tedious, but it works. Maybe we can do something better there too.
Yeah, I think it's. I do think it has to do with an extract and divide.
What would be nice here is to. To sketch a profile on this wall and use that to create a facade inside.
No, that's not a bad idea, because you do the same thing for the way you split up a slab by pores.
Exactly, it's like an opening in the slab, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, what happened? Oh. Everything disappeared.
Building.
My building disappeared. Where's my building? What happened? Okay, I don't know. Anyway, it means it's time.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Other questions? How do you like this concept? Do we still have people here? Or... Graham.
Yeah, no, I'll give it a. I'll certainly give it a go. I'm very interested actually in facades and panelized facades, so it will be interesting.
Okay, cool. Well, do not hesitate to share with us your feedbacks and questions and things like that on the tribe. And,
Well, for the panelized facade in 18x, what we have that simple quick curtain tool, and but there is also panel wall where you can make your own components and use to yeah. plaster them on a wall.
Yes, the panel wall here.
Yeah, no, I've been using the customized components as well, so I'm reasonably familiar with the workflow there.
Okay.
GG, will the panel wall ever work with assemblies?
What do you mean with assemblies?
Not just because right now a panel wall has to use a 3D shape. It can only be one 3D shape within a product.
It can be an assembly, provided that there are no instances in it.
Okay.
Panel wall, it's an assembly that you instantiate, huh?
It's an assembly, but it's just one 3D shape within an assembly. And I've tried before with a...
You are asking if the component that goes in a panel wall can be an assembly.
Yes.
The answer is almost yes, provided that you don't use instances inside that assembly.
Okay.
So if you have two parts of the assembly that are the same, you have to make two references, not an instance of each other.
Yeah, that's okay. I wasn't able to do it in 17x, and I didn't think it was on plan for 18x.
I don't think it did anything to fix it. It just works. Well, try. Don't trust me. Try.
Okay. Oh, you went for the whole face, Thomas?
Yeah, but they're all the same.
That's true.
So what do you have here? Here you have a 3D part.
With a 3D shape.
With a 3D shape. Well,
can you have parts? Can you have one assembly with lots of parts, not just a 3D shape, but many parts in that assembly?
I think as long as you have this publication, GG, you should be able to instantiate an assembly, no?
Yes, but there is a problem if the assembly contains instances.
Okay, I think I did have instances in my assembly.
So let's say your assembly is a symmetrical, so you want to instance half of it.
But if you don't? Yeah, because I had a facade panel with anchors, and my anchors were instances.
Yeah, try without having instances, having all references inside the assembly, and they should work. Last time I tried, it did work.
Okay, but what is the issue, Gigi? Why it's an issue? I don't know.
It has to do with the cloning. I don't know. I don't exactly know what happens.
Ah, okay. Okay.
Because we position only, you have only one positioning, right? We have one axis to position. So, or maybe I don't understand instances. That's also a possibility.
Okay, good. Well, Thomas, thank you very, very much for a
you're welcome.
Very insightful presentation and demo.
You're very welcome. I hope that it inspired some people to play with it.
Inspired me. And I've recorded this, so we'll put it up on the web and hopefully get some more feedback.
Sounds good.
Stop recording.
So maybe I will publish, I will put on the Tribe this Excel file. I will do that right away. Like this, you will know what are the inputs and parameters that you can use.
That would be fantastic. It would also be interesting to start a little collection of templates. If we could upload templates and find a way to track and organize and share templates, in the time being, we can do it internally, but maybe there's a, that way people don't have to go through the effort of rebuilding your
templates. Of course. So that's why it's important to know that we are delivering predefined object types here.
Okay.
So you just need to import those, and then you can reuse the.
Yeah, those are very rudimentary. They're mostly to illustrate what the inputs for the type of templates are.
That's great. Good. Well, thank you very much, Thomas, and thank
You're
you
welcome.
For joining the call.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.